they get you back up?
Sir. This is REZ-2021-28, Windy Hill subdivision located on Miller Bridge. Request is to rezone from EA to R1, which develop a 20-lot subdivision. Again, those lot sizes are ranging from 1.25 acres to 1.74 acres. Due to the median, median pollution susceptibility of the groundwater recharge area, which indicates all lots must be minimum 125% of the requested zone in order to meet public health standards. Concerning the comprehensive plan, again, this is an agricultural forestry area in a rural service area, and therefore, Quarterman zoning is not recommended as a permitted zoning within this area. There is a neighborhood to the south, approximately miles from South Shiloh Ridge, done back in 1999. I believe Mr. Martin was there at that case then. That neighborhood, essentially, lot size is 3 acres, with majority of development and conservation. Today, we would call that type of neighborhood a conservation subdivision, and there are supplemental standards for that. But the request as presented today is R1 on 32 acres in order to develop approximately 20 lots here, one of the lots being a community well site. Given the size of the lot, the community water system may not be necessary, and these sites could support individual wells. Again, site soil evaluation needs to be done by the Department of Public Health to evaluate suitability for each individual site. But overall, TRC found a request inconsistent with the comprehensive plan, but there are no technical objections of note right now with the site plan as presented.
Are there any questions from the commissioners to staff?
Believe it or not.
Commissioner Bailey.
I cannot, I'm trying to wrap my head around this recharge term here. Is this just triggered by zoning? Has the health department been engaged with this yet? Come up with 1.25? I'm just curious, where do we get this from?
This is within the ULDC. It's actually in Chapter 3 of the ULDC regarding wetlands and water recharge area. I have it for you here as well. Homes served by septic drainage fields, lots shall meet the minimum size limitations established by the strictest combination of the standards found in the table 40101G, which is lot sizes, so in your request, and a combination by the Board of Health evaluation. The application of the appropriate susceptibility measurement below 125% of the minimum lot size. Under no circumstances is the minimum lot size established before the application of the susceptibility measure to be less than 15,000 square feet. Again, half acre or larger is typically what the Department of Public Health requires for any kind of septic system. In this case, because of groundwater recharge, which is depicted on our valid JS maps, it requires any lot size to be 125% of the proposed zone.
So, but my question is that flexible with the health department or that's fixed?
That's a fixed standard. Again, it's subject to the Board of Health.
There's no movement on that.
That's a Department of Public Health determines size is based on the request right now. So 1 acre is the request, 1.25 is the minimum based on this standard. If the Department of Public Health deems some of these sites suitable or anything less than that, that would be on them. But the zoning request is R1. And the standard right now, based on this proposal, is 1.25 minimum size.
Portion for this case. Is there anyone here this evening that would like to speak in favor of this case? Please come forward and state your name and address for the record.
My name is Don Tuttle. I'm at 4705 Queensberry Way in Valdosta. I'm one of the two proposed developers on this tract of land. A couple of things that I would like to say about it is I think all of us and all of you on the board realize the demand for additional buildable lots. We have not tried to come in here looking for high density and trying to build something that would be homogeneous with that area. that my research tells me that 1 acre tracts of land are better, up to 2.5 acre tracts are almost non-existent in Lowndes County, much less in the much preferred west, northwest section of Lowndes County. Regardless of the requirement for the panel putting in community water systems, curbs and gutters, and lights, we're trying to put something that people can be proud to live in and not all bunched up in one place. There will be very, very little cost involved, very little to the city of Bay Harbor. Less than 0.5% would be increased for the minimum amount of families that would be using any of their facilities. I would like to also say that just because of word of mouth, as we all know, urban sprawl is upon us, whether we want it to come or not. Fastest growing area in the south of Georgia, we're here. We have had, just by word of mouth only, there's proposed 20 lots. 7 of them have already been spoken for, provided we're granted permission to build this subdivision. We're trying our best to provide for the needs of our county. Sincerely hope that time you look favorably upon our request. Anyone has any questions?
Any questions, Mr. Powell?
Andy would like to speak. He's our attorney.
Andy Smith, that 106.
Say that again, please.
Andy Smith.
Andrew Smith, okay, thank you.
106 East 4th Street, by lot 31601, representing developer and development. First of all, this is not a J.C. Cowler type development, which we all know. Instead, this development is going to have extensive covenants and restrictions, looking for houses to have a minimum size of 2,000 square feet. It will be a homeowners association, so that not only will they have pride, but they will have control over the future of this project. There will be a nice gate placed in the opening to the subdivision, the 20 lots of impact on the traffic will be like in that area. And it offers a good, but unavailable mid-range pricing house that area needs. Questions?
Any questions for Mr. Smith?
One thing I would like to add to it is quite a few years ago, I developed Golden Oak subdivision on Shower Road. That will give you some idea. We built about 60% of the houses. That will give you some idea of the quality that we try to put in whatever.
Mr.
Bates,
please.
You can see all this evening. J.D., I'll address this question to him, but I'd like your input also. If approved, a 1.25 lot could house the septic tank and the well to do away with the community well system. Is that correct?
It's my understanding, based on the public health center at the TRC meeting.
So anything an acre and above can support both of those, the well and septic tank. Just want to make sure we're on the same page here. Mr. Powell, I will tell you, I am severely pro-growth. I agree with what you said. There's tremendous need in our county. I'm tremendously pro-growth. And Mr. Smith, I know you said that the restrictive covenants haven't been developed yet, apparently.
They're in draft form, and of course we can't file them until we get approval.
I'm just curious, we said 2,000 square feet is a minimum square footage.
Yes.
Do we have any exterior, is it going to be vinyl, it'll be concrete sided, any hard surface going to be on there? I'm just curious.
Yes, it will be mixed.
Okay.
There will be no front-facing garages. I just hate to go in the subdivision and see all the trash and litter in somebody else's garage and the garage door open. It's just not a good look for me.
And even though I just said I am severely pro-growth, and I know economics come into play here, I'm just throwing this out there. Has there been a consideration, I know we got some lot between 1.25 and 1.7, I believe, has there been a consideration about doing something, a flat 2.5 acre size? I'm just curious, has that been considered at all? I know the economics come into play.
We have two individuals that have already spoken that they want 2 acres, 2 plots each, which would be 2.5 acres for one person.
I'm just curious, is there any consideration to map the whole subdivision out for 2.5 acres?
We are hoping, because of the economic impact, that would not be necessary.
I get that, sir.
When you take a look at everything, well, down to dollars and cents.
Any other questions? Have questions for the gentleman?
That's a good question.
In this economic time, I would say 2,000 square feet, you're going to be looking and rocking it by that something around $300,000. Not a budget.
Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you very much.
One more question, Mr. Powell, I'm right there. This rendering that we have before is now, we got several places for stormwater. Is there any place designated, if approved, well size going to be? Am I just not seeing it?
Yes, sir. If you look on the where the large tract of land is, the little sliver lot that's right behind it, that's set aside for the well. On the bottom.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. We still have a few minutes in this portion. Is there anyone else here who would like to speak in favor of this case? All right. Is there anyone here this evening that would like to speak against this case? Please come forward and state your name and address.
Brad Folsom. 2611 North Patterson Street, I'm here representing a group of concerned citizens, most of whom are residents of this area, and many of whom are adjacent to this parcel. I'll hand to me here, we all on for the record. There are 303 folks who signed a petition against this particular parcel and against this rezone. As you know, this is in a agricultural, forestry, conservation character area. Most of the land in and around this parcel of land is agricultural in use. There is almost unanimous opposition from property owners from an area really starting at Shiley Road going all the way to 122 and west of 75. And I'll show you on this map here, you can all see this is the subject property. Every one of these parcels that is in light color has signed the petition against this rezone. And that gives you a good visual representation of the folks and what they feel. I wanted to also let you know, just looking at the parcels in this general area, there are only 19 parcels that are zoned R1 and that kind of swath of land west of the interstate. Of those 19, only 4 of those are as small as 1 to 2 acres. Of all the parcels that are, the average size is 3.32 acres of those 19 parcels. We have to, as a community, encourage growth. I'm on the development authority. I said it in Alice here 4 or 5 years ago. I appreciate your service because I know what it takes to be up there. But we have to also be very smart about that growth. We have to look to develop things adjacent to existing residential density areas around urban should also know that the applicant is exactly right, that this is the western, northwest part of the county. It's a high demand area. You've probably also heard in other cases before in recent months. And going up Valdo Road, there's about 750 lots right now ready to build. There's another 1,300 or so acres that's ready to be sold, ready to be developed. So there's plenty of opportunity for development, existing and also in the future. That indicates that we shouldn't go out into the middle of an absolute agricultural area where people have been using that land for agriculture for years and years and years and place a one-off development out of the middle of it. That will only seek to, you know, hurt the character of that area, hurt our number one driver of our economy in Lowndes County agriculture, you know, hurt the people who are traveling up and down those roads with agricultural vehicles. Yeah, and quite frankly, you know, being in the middle of a aquifer recharge area, which I think that same map will just hold that up, that big swath of yellow coming down there is the aquifer recharge area that really takes up this entire area. And the less building that we can have in that area, the better it is for our environment. You know, I said the comprehensive plan indicates goals to place new development within or adjacent to existing urban or service areas. This is well away from either. This is at a minimum, at least about two, I think I measured 2.3 miles from the city limits of AR, which is your next densest area. There's a little bit of development just north of here, all larger lots, none as small as these. The roads in this area, I think Mr. Dillard and his report indicated this is a minor collector road, not built for this kind of traffic. It doesn't have the width or the capability to carry another 100, 150 cars a day out of any of the subdivision. You know, the drainage and retention is a big issue already in this area. Mr. Dillard pointed out the groundwater recharge area requirements on the ULDC. The smarter development of our county absolutely dictates that these areas should be the least likely for subdivision development. As of now, in this area, within that recharge area, the average parcel size is 27.92 acres. And that's looking at 266 tax parcels. That's a sobering statistic when you look at putting in 21.25 acre lots on one road, one way in, as nice as they may be. And there's no doubt that the plans of the development seem to be very nice. It's just simply in the absolute wrong area. There's plenty of places that could be put and done well and would serve our county well. But in the middle of an agricultural area that's not even planned for in any comprehensive plan for growth of this type, is the wrong thing to do by this commission and the wrong message to send to anybody else wanting to develop land. Finally, the importance of agricultural land in our community cannot be overstated, especially with the growth that's happening. We are fortunate that this county's grown by about 10,000 people over the last census 10 years to about 116,000 people. That's great, and we need to put those folks in the right areas. But we also need to protect, you know, the existing land to the best extent we can, and this is an easy way to protect it. There's really no indication from the GLPC, from staff, from anybody, that this is an appropriate zone for this area. So I would ask that you recommend the denial of this rezoning request. Thank you.
Commissioners, any questions for Mr. Folsom?
Brent, I do agree. I mean, everything you said was spot on. The fact, you know, you do sit on the industrial authority. You're charged with bringing businesses here, and then that trickle down effect is we need the subdivision development. And as been stated tonight, you're absolutely right, it's one of the most desirable areas in the county. And everybody wants, I'm going to say it's going to work big with FEMA, but it's the fact everybody wants developments until it's in their backyard. And I get all that, I do. It's just tricky sometimes, it is. But I do appreciate you coming forward tonight and speaking on behalf of the other homeowners.
Only thing I'll say about it is it's tricky in some areas, it's not tricky here. This is as clear as any place in the county you'll find. Tricky is Valdo Road. Tricky is 41. This area is completely agricultural. It's not tricky at all.
But it's been tricky areas before.
Absolutely. Y'all seen 4 or 5 of them just recently.
Yeah.
I've been in front of county commission on a couple. Yeah. But this one's not tricky. Just be clear about that.
Thank you, Mr. Bowles. Thank you very much. We still have a little time. Is there anyone else here tonight that would like to speak against this case? So please come forward. Gretchen.
My name is Gretchen Quarterman. I live at 6565 Quarterman Road. I'm here on behalf of the Wells Watershed Coalition. One of the things that we do is advocate on behalf of the rivers in our area. This isn't particularly close to the river, but it's on the aquifer recharge zone. Every single person that drinks in this county drinks from that aquifer. Right now, the dump sits on the aquifer recharge zone. We do not need to in any way endanger the aquifer recharge zone. We need to preserve it.
Anyone else that would like to speak against this case? Given the number of citizens who have come out, we will allow a little extra time. Is anyone else who would like to speak against this case? Yes, sir. Please come forward.
My name is David Adams. The property to the...
What's your address, Mr. Adams?
It's in Knobhill.
Knobhill.
The property that you see that's across the road, the larger track here next to the green spot on the map. This piece of property that my brother's and I own along with dad, that property was originally a farming operation in which my dad and I raised cows, we baled hay, we grew corn, soybeans. The problem with the property that you see there is the backside of that property is along the Little River. The Little River, as you know, merges into the Little Coochie south of town. That property, we've spent thousands of dollars building levees, or not levees, I guess, contours into the property to prevent erosion. And of course, the cows have a tendency to carry that stuff down over time. So my dad decided later on with the roll of the land and the flow of the water that came from across the property over there to do the contours of the property and install 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 retention ponds across that property. Each one of them were graded. Each one of them were used by the extension agency here in Lowndes County so that that water would directly from retention area to retention area to retention area, so that it would be captured before it went into the Little River. Now, later on, the farm was leased to the Burtons over in Brooks County, who farmed the property that you see there in the open land. The rest of it had been planted in pine trees, which was supported by the state of Georgia and helped fund the placement of that. Now, that road was paved several years ago because it was a washboard road. The Shiloh Road was the main connector up towards Hayhira from Valdosta. And the citizens there pay taxes for that road just as much as anybody else in the county pays for their roads. Finally got it approved and got it in there. The other thing that's instrumental in this property is we're talking about 25 houses. Septic tanks, if there's a well, the county will inherit the well. I'm not sure if the county really wants another well to administer. So if septic tanks and wells go in, that's an obvious challenge for that community. It is a rural, agricultural, farming operation community up there. And the people up there, obviously, there's 299 other people back here behind me that do not want it. Now, with that said, I don't want 400 acres to provide a recreation area for 25 families across the road. We've seen the growth that's happened on Valdale. I remember Valdale Road before there was ever a house out there. Mm-hmm. And now we're faced with traffic issues coming in on the north end of town. I've seen the growth on 41, which there's plenty of room for growth up along behind Grove Point that is sectioned for development. This is just a spot on the map for somebody to build 25 houses, which I'm not opposed for people building houses. But what I am opposed to is piecemealing stuff together where you get a excessive traffic. You get the flow for 25 families to install or to admit to the north end of the county school systems, which are already full. And I don't think that there is sufficient, I may be wrong, but I don't think there's sufficient coverage by Southport Medical Center and Emergency Management Services for that end of the county. We do have a volunteer fire department. But at this point in time, it's not that I'm unopposed to growth, but this is not the type of growth that this community wants or needs.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Chairman, nothing else to say. These folks are going to be real mad if you don't see everybody here against this. So if y'all will raise your hand.
Time has expired. So the public hearing portion on this case is closed. Commissioners, any other comments or questions among ourselves on this case? The chair will entertain a motion. Commissioner Bailey.
Mr. Chairman, on the case set before us this evening, REZ-2021-28, I propose Windy Hill Subdivision at Miller Bridge Road. And as I've stated many times, I am severely pro-growth. And I know we use terms tonight like spot zoning and character area, and I always don't agree with those things because they're sometimes made to be massaged a little bit. But on this particular case, I would feel much better if the lots were 2.5 acres as a minimum. And for that reason, sir, I would make a motion this evening on this case set before us of denial from EA to R1.
Okay, we have a motion to deny on this case from Commissioner Bailey and a second by Commissioner Willis. Motion to deny on this case. That's correct. All those in favor of the motion to deny, please signify by raising your right hand. So the motion is denied. The case is denied.